Welcome back to Temple of Elemental Evil and all of that. Where am I? How am I doing on my quests? Masterwork items and all this stuff up at the top we're not doing. I suppose. Let's just continue to walk around. I do need to go talk to Terzian, don't I? You know, while I'm at it, I don't even know what this is. Then again, you know, even if I don't remember, it's worth going into since, you know, there's quests pretty much everywhere. Hi? The cabinet maker. You, if I remember correctly, you weren't really important at all in the previous game. I think now he is reasonably decent. You know, it's not fantastic. You know, a shield, the great clubs, javelins, and, you know, quivers and whatnot. It's not too bad. Not too bad. I believe... after you take care of the spiders in the Delco Grove, now in... there we go. Yep, see? It's the Delco Grove. Fat lot of help you are. No. Yeah. So I'll be able to talk to him about... that. Is that a quest, or is that just, yeah, that's just a thing. Go talk to him. He says, oh, go kill spiders for me. And that'll pretty much take care of it. There might be an option that I have to speak to the woodcutter about it too. I doubt it. Why am I walking there? There's a little thing that you can do. Also, two-headed sheep. Another one. And the strange thing is, in another part of town... there isn't that problem.
Get off my land, stranger. I'll not be tolerating the likes of you.
Wow, your voice acting is amazing.
I am sometimes called Black Jay. What is it to you?
What are you called the rest of the time?
Quit wasting my time and get off my property.
Get off my lawn!
Yes. What is... what do you want...
oh. Originally, he does have a small quest to do. But apparently he...
I am carrying too much.
Really? Really? The weight is one. I think actually in the, original game, they weighed 10.
Yes. What do you want?
You know, you're a druid. You should be able to go, oh, blah, blah, blah. But this hemlock is part of a quest later.
As you wish.
Yeah. I'm surprised he doesn't give it. Maybe he does give quests. There are quests from Black Jay. But for some reason, I've tried multiple times. I can't get him to give the quest, so I don't know what it's about. They're not, you know, fantastic quests or any of that. They're just, you know, some little bits and pieces. And you're buffing yourself. There are a lot of people in... stop it. There are a lot of new NPCs. Like, these guys... I don't remember these guys from the game at all. That's nice. We're not going to talk to the,
okay.
Cleric and his little boy band. We're actually going to talk to this woman. Hello? I'm a cook, maid, gardener, and whatever else the cannon needs to be done. I'd probably have to clean and change him too, but I think Brother Calmert does it. When we meet Calmert, and I actually talk to him, yeah, with having fun at his expense, I have no problem with it. Terzian's a bit of a stuffy fusspot. As much as I'd like to, I don't think I could possibly get that into normal day conversation. I'm gonna try, though. The Kenaness. If you start out as neutral good, the game pretty much starts off with, oh look, the Kenaness is dead. I'm not kidding. Ah. How much flour do you need? 3 sacks of flour. Alright, let's, why not? Ew. It mentions a green dragon in the original game. I am pretty sure there was no dragon in this game. Yeah, with something called Dungeons and Dragons? Yeah. I don't know about now that, you know, level 11 through 20 has been added. I have no idea. If there's not, I'm going to be very upset. I mean, dungeons, which is going to be taken care of profusely, and dragons. You know, 1 through 10? Okay, no dragon? That's fine. 11 through 20, if we don't have a dragon, I'm gonna throw a temper tantrum like a small child. Yeah, that's it. I just wanted to get that quest. It's one that you just walk around humbling.
A mere fraction of my power.
Yes. I wanted to show something, but I can't remember what it was. Oh, by the way, that game for experience in the last part, 0. Lily, will you please talk to this cleric?
Welcome to the Church of St. Cuthbert. I am Calmet. Please feel free to peruse the tracts and scrolls of our religion, or take a seat on our bench here. The poor box is located on the far table as well.
If you think the poor box thing and, his not-so-subtle hinting is a huge hint. Yeah, I'm gonna stop talking about that. Yeah, he is very involved with the poor box. However, yeah.
I'm afraid the chief cleric Terrigen is busy at the moment.
Is he?
Still, he might find time in exchange for a small donation to the poor box.
Basically, this jerkface will not let you do a damn thing in the church without making a donation. I'm not kidding. I know what Terzian normally is. I don't believe if I go there, he will be there. He's literally, like, not there. He doesn't spawn until you donate. I think. I'm, like, 75% sure on that.
Well, all the money goes for the good of the church. At the moment, much of our money is helping build the tower in the southeast corner of town, all in the name of St. Cuthbert of Torres.
Of course.
The Viscount and the Archcleric of Valuna have requested the funds from us to help build the castle for Burnley and Rufus, who have been most helpful in the protection of the followers of St. Cuthbert, including slaying a green dragon in the Crone Hills.
To be fair, them helping the Church of St. Cuthbert helping, you know, Bernie and Rufus build the castle, I guess, you know, slaying a green dragon, which aren't really that dangerous. Well, for adventurers, they're not that dangerous, usually. But, you know, for normal folk, it's a dragon, it doesn't matter.
How can I be of service, miss? Remember, St. Cuthbert rewards those who give freely to the needy.
Yes, I know.
Yes.
Oh, you actually... Wow, I do not have that much money. 26,000 gold points. That is a holy mace plus one. That's actually a really good item. Silver light mace, that's not too bad either. The way silver works in D&D, as I remember it, is Think of it this way. There's masterwork, and then there's plus one weapons. Silver's somewhere between them, I think. And silver, as far as effectiveness on monsters, like some monsters, you need at least plus one to even do damage to them. Some, like some lycanthropes, require at least silver, or, you know, plus one weapons. As far as damaging, hopefully that all made sense. And plus one weapons get by damage reduction, and blah blah blah. I could go on about rules, but that's boring. RPG, you're doing a whole bunch of random quests, welcome not really getting anything done, and you're talking about rules being boring.
Remember, I'm afraid the chief.
Yeah, fine.
Thank you for your kind donation.
Yeah, yeah. He's literally right upstairs.
Yes.
And to be honest, it's 10 gold. 10 gold, if you were a peasant, is like a lifetime saving. 10 gold is a lot of money. Some smaller communities never even see a gold fees. For adventurers, yeah, not so much. Anyway, Lily, could you please talk to this very important priest?
Welcome to the Church of St. Cuthbert, friend. I am Canon Turgeon.
Nice to meet you.
How can I help you?
Let's see. Let's, try to get on his good side before we talk about, you know, converting people away from St. Cuthbert.
Our church was built 8 years ago after the war against the Temple of Elemental Evil in honor of the Archcleric of Valuna, who brought St. Cuthbert's assistance to the war. Canon Aside was the first chief cleric here, and my predecessor.
Oh, I already told you what happened with her.
St. Cuthbert of the Cudgel exacts revenge and just punishment on those who transgress the law. He was once a mortal man who ascended to godhood long ago. He has been known to intervene when the Old One shows up, but we won't speak more of that.
The Old One, and there I go dropping my phone. Yeah, we'll find out more about that. Temple of Elemental Evil.
The Temple of Elemental Evil was destroyed in the wars about 10 years back. Its ruins remain an evil place. Unfortunately, I lost a great personal treasure to myself in those wars.
Did you now?
I lost an artifact of St. Cuthbert. It is a copper starburst pendant, not worth much to anyone else, really, but of great personal value to me. My father, rest his soul, gave it to me as a family heirloom when I became chief cleric in Willip.
More quests!
Most likely in the Battle of Emrady Meadows. I've searched everywhere in that meadow, but I have been unable to locate it. For finding such a thing, I would gladly lower rates for my services.
Trust me, he didn't look very hard.
Thanks, and good luck. The last place in that forsaken meadow I remember holding it was by a beautiful multicolored rock hidden from normal view. If you can find that in the meadow, it would be a good place to start.
We can go to Emrady Meadows, like, right away. There's a giant there, if you remember the masterwork quest. Yeah, we're not doing that yet. Most of everything there is just skeletons, which is perfectly safe for a level 1 party, especially with my cleric who has improved turning, and he can just destroy low-level skeletons, like, in one turn. It's going to be fantastic. more questions, please.
How can I help you?
Yeah, the improved turning, all it does is, he's level 1, he turns as level 2. When he becomes level 2, he'll be level 3. He's going to have more stuff. That's just something that I threw in there, because it's like, why not? Actually, I'm kind of regretting it. I could probably find much better things, but most of the feats that I'm thinking of, the improved turnings of feat, yeah, most of it's later levels, so I'm not really worried about it. Anyway, I have questions about performing conversions to St. Cuthbert.
I can perform conversions here in my church, providing a willing convert who can prove worthy in the eyes of St. Cuthbert.
From St. Cuthbert.
Blasphemy! That cannot be allowed.
That is too bad. He is a good man and he is in love. Poor Merrick.
He is a good man because St. Cuthbert helps him to be so. I will not allow him to throw that away.
Oh.
How can I help you? I can
perform
conversions here in my church. Blasphemy! That cannot be allowed.
You want to know what kind of guy this guy is?
I suppose that might be fair. There is a villager I've been trying to get to convert for some time now, Jack Borden, the leather worker. If you could convince him to convert, I might be willing to let Merrick go.
Yeah, well, I have to talk to him anyway because of, you know... Actually, don't I already have a quest about that, the conversion thing? Where is it? Or I have not picked that up. There it is. Yeah, so this all plays into that. Have you noticed that most of these side quests are all involved? Anyway, Avil. You, traditionally were very self-absorbed in gaining power. Let's steal things.
Look at all that loot.
Please never talk like that again. Let's take all. Okay, thankfully, you know, I know it doesn't make your paladin go fallen. She didn't say it anyway, so it's fine.
Whatever you say.
It doesn't make them go fallen, which makes them lose all of their paladin powers, which, to be fair, she doesn't really have that many.
Whatever you say.
And then, to fix that, I would need to get someone to cast Atonement on me. It's a spell. Level 1, of course, I don't have things, stats on, but not stats. Access to that spell myself. So that's a problem. And usually, getting an atonement spell, if you're playing pencil and paper, it's pretty much required that you do some sort of quests. Another reason why I don't play paladins. Like, whenever I play D&D, I never. If I ran the world, it's like, no, you can't be a paladin.
By the gods, will.
Seriously, it's that kind of thing. Where's... Yeah, don't recruit the man-at-arms. Can I tell you that again? Really, really don't.
Welcome to the Hamlet Trading Post. Yes?
Yeah, anyway. I still want to know what the difference between fine scale mail and regular scale mail is. There's no weight difference. It's a battle bikini, I guess. And you have the same exact inventory as the other guy for some reason. Though you are separate beings.
Of course.
Let's see. I need to go to the miller, correct? That's that guy. I don't think there's anything involved with this guy. With this building. I don't think they give anything. Actually, I don't remember this building being important at all. Come to think of it. Oh yeah, the trading post is a little bit shifty. No, thank you. I'll leave. He's gives you a hint that the
yes.
Trading post isn't as. On the up and up, shall we say. Yeah. Whose house is this?
Very well.
I don't even remember. You guys are the something? Cowherd, yeah. I don't mean
right
cattle.
Away.
Let's actually go to the miller and work on one of these quests that I have. I've only picked up like another 6. Right. Lily! Oh. What is this? Oh. I could talk to him for you. If you talk to this servant and bluff and say that you talked to the miller, even though he's in the room and he knows you didn't, at some point this guy will lose his job and become a bum. Yeah, let's not do that. Ah, I think they would say balance in all things. Sound just like Jeru. Yay! So, you know, one little conversation. I don't even think it's that difficult as far as, I think it's diplomacy goes. It's actually quite easy. And that gained me... That's 50... That is 60 experience? Really? For, well, you figure 6 people, 60 times 6. That's pretty damn easy. A few more questions. Donation of flour to the church of St. Cuthbert. Remember, he's of the old faith. He probably is against it. No, Myella sent me. Oh, we could talk to Jeru. Alright.
Of course.
In one little conversation in one building, I gained more experience than I did in like 3 parts. Almost. Like 2.5. Ugh. Actually, let's just go talk to Jeru. I mean, he's not that far. Okay, he is kind of far away. Where else am I going? Oh, I need to talk to Jacques the leatherworker guys, don't I? They're over here. I can actually start completing quests. Holy crap! Oh, wait. I forgot. Yeah, I need to make sure I don't run around stupid, because otherwise the game will crash. But anyway, net gain for this part, 60 experience. Woo! Until next time. Hey, it's something. And you know what? Part 5, I'm actually going to start completing stuff. I know. It's amazing. I know what you're thinking. RPG, could you please go kill something? It's part 4 and we haven't seen anything die yet, and it's a Dungeons & Dragons game. Wait, there's going to be lots of time to murder stuff, especially when we actually reach the Temple of Elemental Evil. Holy crap, is there going to be a lot of things to murder. Until then.